Hello, guys. Oh my gosh, my tongue is brown from drinking coffee. Also, peep the mug. Shout out to Jake's sister, Jamie, for getting me that mug. It is Monday, March 13th, which eerily enough is the 3-year anniversary of, I know, like when my school where I was teaching at the time got shut down. It's basically the 3-year anniversary of when the pandemic like really jumped into high gear. So that's kind of crazy, but it is Monday, which means it's the first day of my spring break. I mean, like I had the weekend, obviously, and I haven't vlogged in a really long time, so I thought I would. And the really exciting thing is that the Eras Tour is in like 4 days. It's on Friday, and I am very fortunate to be going on both nights that it's here in Arizona. It's gonna be at the Glendale Stadium where the Cardinals play. So it'll be on Friday. And on Saturday, so I am buzzing. Like I am just losing my marbles, thinking about it nonstop. I have been thinking so much about what the set list is gonna be. It's just been a lot. So I figured we should vlog and just have fun this week. Nothing too crazy is planned except for obviously the Eras Tour, and I have some friends coming into town for that. So on this Monday morning with my Never Grow Up shirt and my banana leaf leggings, I'm actually headed to work. I'm headed to school. I don't know. Usually when we have breaks, I like to put in a few hours of work actually at the classroom just because it's really nice to do it when you have no interruptions, nothing going on. You don't have school the next day. You don't have school the day before. Like it's just, you know, so I'm gonna go in, do some stuff, and then hopefully not stay too long. That's the plan. I think I'm gonna pick up a coffee along the way. So I'll see you there. Oh, that's right. And I was going to show you my perfume of the day. I think I'm going to go with this guy, which is Jo Malone French Lime Blossom. Okay. Historically in the past, this trip is actually on my channel here if you want to search for it, but I was in Hawaii 4 years ago, not like now in March. It was a month ago. It would have been in February 4 years ago. I was in Hawaii and this was the scent that I wore there. It was like my Hawaii scent. Not even 5 years ago. Anyway, it was like close to spring break and I feel like the weather is turning. It's starting to get to be spring, which in Arizona is a really dangerous thing because then it's going to be summer real quick and like deathly hot real quick. But for right now, the weather is still pretty nice. And yeah, this is so good. It's like fresh and summery. You smell that hint of lime, like that hint of citrus. Yeah, let's make that the scent of spring break. I don't know if I'm actually gonna wear it every day during spring break, but maybe. Okay, bye. Okay guys, we're here at school in the parking lot and I thought we would try this together. This is the new, I don't even know what it's called, cinnamon caramel cream something something cold brew from Starbucks. Let's try it. Ooh, a bit of an aftertaste there. It kind of tastes like cinnamon dolce, but like with the foam on top. Very good. Okay, so I'm in my classroom now and I remembered that the city of Glendale is changing its name for 2 days while Taylor's here on the 17th and 18th. And I'm pretty sure it's being announced today. So like, let's look it up. Glendale name change. Oh, Swift City. I mean, that's cute. I feel like it could have been more creative, but it'll be Swift City. Honestly, it's gonna be Swift City forever, not just for 2 days. Oh, this is cute. There's like shirts. Swift City, established March of 2023. That's amazing. Where can I get one of those shirts? Okay, time to do work. I'm so excited. I got an email that my book order box came. So I went down to the office to get it. And actually the only kid in my class who ordered books, I just also tacked on books. It doesn't matter. I'm like kind of friends with her mom. Like we have each other's cell phone numbers and I know where they live. They live around the corner. And I was like, I can just bring these to her if you want. And so when I leave here, I'm gonna drop them off at my student's house. Her mom was like, she would die if you did that. So I'm excited to see her. All right, there's always, always, always more to do, but I was here for a good 3+ hours I'm gonna go drop these books off at my girl's house and head home. Okay, I'm home. That was a real blast. I did not show when I was over at their house, but it was so cute. My student was like so surprised to see me. And then her little sister too. I'm home now. And I think next up, we're gonna bake this king cake, even though it's March. And Mardi Gras is like over, but I love king cake and I wanna bake this. It don't look like much now, but oh baby, it's cooling. And then we do the frosting and the, or like the glaze and the sugar crystals. It doesn't quite look like the box, but there we go. Don't mind the really terrible quality of my record player. I'm looking to upgrade. But I was just playing Folklore while my phone was charging. So I was like, let me play music with this. So pretty. I think I'm gonna go out on a really short run / walk. We'll see how I'm feeling, what the vibes are. Before I get ready to head over to Jake's, we're gonna watch the Suns game, eat dinner, and I might stay the night there. So I was gonna hang out with a work friend tonight, but she had to reschedule. So I think we're gonna hang out on Wednesday, but there's like a big Suns game tonight. So yeah, let me go get out of the house, get a little movement, and then I'll see you after that. Back home. Good morning from me and these barky, barky dogs. I'm about to head back to my house to get ready to head out to my laser hair removal appointment. I forgot to finish vlogging last night, but the Suns game was not a good one. And then me and Jake watched Buffy the Vampire Slayer and went to bed. And now you're caught up. All right, y'all, just pulled up to my laser hair removal. Right. They're very attractive.
Oh yeah, right.
All right, well, we're all done. Short and sweet. I think I'm gonna head to this outdoor shopping complex. I've been there before on a vlog on my way home because I kinda wanna stop by an Ulta because it's the 21 Days of Beauty sale and I wanna see the product in person to see like if I feel like it's worth it on my limited budget, you know? And then where else did I wanna stop? I feel like there was somewhere else. Target, which is there. I feel like there was something else. I don't know. We'll just see which way the wind blows us. Probably gonna get a coffee because I'm fortunately pretty wealthy in terms of Starbucks money because I'm a teacher. Very grateful for that. Can definitely go treat myself to a coffee if I'm feeling one, which I'm kind of never not. So, all right, let's do this. Oh, and I wanna work on some YouTube stuff today and I think I'm finally going to react. I kind of keep forgetting to, but like, oh my gosh, I have not listened to Hits Different by Taylor or the two alternate versions of, I think it's Sweet Nothing and I don't even know what else. You're On Your Own, Kid, maybe? Maybe not. But it's on the Target CD. And I think I'm gonna react to it because the tour is on Friday and like, what if she plays? I mean, she probably won't. I don't know, who knows? But that's what's on the agenda. So, let's go. I ended up getting a few things at Bath & Body Works and I picked up one makeup item at Ulta. Bath & Body had their soaps on sale and I've been waiting for them to have their soaps on sale. So that worked out. I'm gonna pop over to this Target because I have to pee and I want a Starbucks and you know, I always love going to a Target, especially when it's like not the usual Target I go to. I feel like that's like fun to look at different Targets. And then, I don't know, we'll probably head home or towards my house because I'm not trying to film that reaction video like here in this busy parking lot. I am going to be filming it in my car because the CD is like in my car and it's that song's not streaming anywhere. So anyway, I don't think I'd be able to really be myself here in this parking lot. So let's go get our caffeine and our Target look on and then we'll see where we end up filming. So I saw this online the other day and it's kind of like a new, almost like a dupe fragrance line at Target. Like this smells exactly like Tom Ford Lost Cherry. This, I don't know, I need to smell them all, but That's exciting. What does this one smell like? You guys remember that, what was it called? It was the pink swirly bottle, and it was like really affordable and very sweet. I think it started with an A. That's what this smells like. The musk one kind of smells like Le Labo, another 13. Sunforia. Ooh, I like that. Ooh, I really like that one. Oh my gosh. It smells a little bit like, there's one by Nest called like Sun Blossom something. Hibiscus, Sun Hibiscus. That's kind of what this smells like. Okay, Jungle Santal. Oh, that kind of smells like Le Labo Santal 33, a little bit. I mean, all in all, this is great. Ooh, that smells like something, but I can't put my finger on it. Come smell them. Y'all, I'm for real debating this for like recess duty and bus duty. It's a little ridiculous, but that Arizona sun is harsh. This stuff is amazing. I have a couple shirts from this brand. I have one with Rosa, but those are so cool. All right, I'm home. I went to the bathroom, let Camille out, put the things away that needed to be put away, and now I'm gonna go find a spot in my neighborhood to awkwardly park and film this reaction. I'm so excited to listen to a new Taylor song. All right, I filmed my reaction. I obviously loved Hits Different and loved the remixes. And now I'm just having a little salad break, watching some Housewives. And then in a couple of hours, Jake's gonna come over. Cause today's like kind of sort of our anniversary. It's the anniversary of the day that we started talking as more than just friends. Our official anniversary isn't until May, but we're gonna have dinner over here and then we're gonna go to like this sports bar that we really love to watch the Suns game. And they have really good drinks. So salad time and Housewives time until Jake gets here. Okay, just got out of the shower, hence why I'm not showing you myself, but I'm gonna get ready for, I told you, like little date night things with Jake. So this is the scent of the night, Alien. I don't have a lot of time, and also I couldn't find the original inspiration picture that I found, but I saw this really pretty eyeshadow look that was orange and purple, which are the sun's colors. So we're gonna try to make that. Don't mind this. Hello. The purple doesn't show up as much.
Yeah, you look real cute
though. Oh, thank you. I have purple highlighter on too. I kind of need more like a lavender haze shade, but it'll work. I did it kind of quick too. Cannoli. The couple that I hate, aka the ones who sit by each other. No offense, peace and love to you if you're that couple. But you know, the nice view of the Suns game is right there. So, and we're not having dinner, so it's not like, you know, we're just having drinks and watching the game. Cheers, babe. Also, I put on a purple scrunchie. Did you notice? I put on a purple scrunchie. Sky, you are more than just a bad light. We're home. Suns didn't win.
Yeah, it's all right, though.
It's all right, though. Okay, good night. I think we're going to watch Ted Lasso. Hello, it's a rainy Wednesday morning and I am having some coffee and getting ready to head out towards my mom's part of town to hang out with her.
Storage. You're taking a picture of the dog. Is he resting?
Yeah, well,
is she wearing
you out? I put my head down by him and oh! Yeah, that thing's very cute.
I thought maybe jewelry storage or something.
Let me see the inside. Do you want to say hi to the vlog?
No.
Hey, oh. I'm at my mom's
now. Look, that mirror's already filled.
Is there a sleeve? Hi.
And I said, when is the in-flight beverage service going to be getting?
I think it's just like a city candle. This is like the egg chair of all egg chairs. So it's cold and rainy and dark. And I fully feel like I am back in Portland at Cascade Station. Like, you could not convince me otherwise just by looking at this. It's like this outdoor little strip. Cascade Station. Miss you, Portland. Okay, leaving my mom's now. So fun. She bought me this REM Beauty. This is after me washing my hands like a couple of times. I'll have to show you later, but it's that Ariana Grande brand, and it's like this liquid glitter eyeshadow that's like purpley, because I was thinking, you know, I like kind of want to do a lavender haze eyeshadow look for one of the nights of the tour. I don't know, but my mom bought it for me, so that was sweet. I think I'm gonna stop at Trader Joe's on the way home and then head home. I'm hanging with my friend Sarah tonight, so I have a few hours in between now and then. Let's see how many of them I waste away just by being aimless and doing the things that I do. I'm home now. I did not putz around for too long. And I'm tired, so I am chilling here on the couch watching a little bit of H3 podcast. And then I'm gonna get ready in like a couple hours to head over to my friend Sarah's. I think I told you I was doing that. She's my teacher friend who lives in this neighborhood. I may or may not walk to her house. It is walking distance, but it's like on and off raining and cold, so we'll see. But just wanted to check in. Big chillin' right now. On the way to my girl Sarah's house, bringing wine, bringing chocolates, full cozy mode. Let's do this.
A whole channel of Taylor Swift.
What does that mean? It's a whole channel.
My parents have like on-demand music channels.
Oh my gosh, I'm obsessed.
And
hi guys, it's like 11:30 p.m. I hung out with Sarah way longer than I thought, but it was super fun. I am, however, going to say goodnight for right now. I was thinking of ending the vlog today on Wednesday and then like picking it back up Thursday through Sunday for the rest of spring break, because that'll be like when I go to Taylor and stuff. But I want to include like a little segment in this vlog about kind of my predictions and like hopes for the Eras tour. So maybe I will film that in the morning and then edit. But yeah, I'm gonna say goodnight to you and see you in the morning. Maybe I'll watch The Bachelor right now. Catch up. Hello guys, it's Thursday morning. Finishing up The Bachelor. I did not watch all of it last night because it was the regular episode and then the women tell all. Taylor Swift just posted that she's releasing 4 songs tonight. And I'm pretty sure, okay, so it was Eyes Open, Safe and Sound. So those are both from like the Hunger Games soundtrack. Oh shoot, what was the other one? If This Was a Movie, which is that a bonus track on Speak Now? It is, right? So like this begs the question, is Speak Now Taylor's version coming? Anyway, and then the last one was called All the Girls You've Loved Before or whatever. And I'm pretty sure that is the song that has been going around TikTok as an unreleased lover song. And I caved and listened to like a TikTok sound of it, and it was incredible what I heard, and like the vocals were insane. And I'm so excited if that's the song she's releasing. And that feels very her, like, okay, I know this is on TikTok, let me release it. Especially since if it was a lover era track that didn't make it, like she's not doing lover Taylor's version because she already owns it, you know what I mean? So this is also exciting. And yes, like I told you last night, my plan is to eventually, I'm still in like coffee and chill mode, but eventually like make my Eras tour kind of vibe, prediction, hopes, dreams section of this vlog, and then edit it, and then I'll do the rest of the vlog for the rest of the week and the tour. Wait, they're announcing The Bachelorette? And it's charity? I love that. Oh, I love it! Is this real? Oh my God, she's so deserving. In my head, I was just talking about who I want to be the next Bachelorette. I would have loved to see Brooklyn or Gabby, but like we need another Black Bachelorette, and I love Charity. Yay! Just putting some sparkly gloss on for good measure. Hi guys, this is a segment within this vlog, even though I'm filming this kind of like a sit-down style video, but basically Eras Tour is tomorrow, and I have thought a lot about what she's gonna do. I know everybody has. There's been theories and stuff on TikTok. You know, I haven't like spent too much time going down that rabbit hole because part of me is just like anxious about it and just wants to see. But now that it's literally tomorrow, I'm like, okay, I'm ready to fathom and like see what I think. And part of me wonders if she is going to do like literally go through the eras, like only do Taylor Swift songs, then Fearless, Speak Now, so on and so forth. Or if it is gonna kind of be similar to how Rep Tour was, which was like where she opened with Ready For It, like will she open with Lavender Haze, you know, cause that's her most recent track one. And then just go through a lot of her songs, a lot of her new songs. Mind you, this woman has 4 additional albums plus hella vault tracks and stuff like that since she last toured. But and then like within the show, go back and do your debut, Speak Now, Red, etc. So I really don't know. And let me preface by obviously saying I'm going to be so happy no matter what she does. I'm so excited and grateful to go. But this is where I am. I made 3 playlists. The first one is things that I think we will hear. These are ones that I think are like shoe in. She kind of has to play them. It's a lot of the singles. And I put them on this playlist because the next playlist is things that I would love to hear. And there is some crossover, but for sure between these 2 playlists. Like, and basically if it's on the would love to hear it, there's a chance I think we might hear it, like based on it being a single or whatever, but it's just that I wanna hear it more than the ones on this playlist. Like no shade, obviously every Taylor Swift song is the best song of all time, but she only has so much time to perform, you know what I'm saying? Starting with debut, I'm not gonna play you every song obviously, but I do think we're gonna hear our song. I think it's just like such an iconic, you know, fan favorite. I love our song a lot. But for me, out of my, actually, let me do it like that. Like the thing we'll hear, blah, 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 and just go through each kind of era, as opposed to going through the whole thing we'll hear, love to hear, would die to hear. Did I tell you that? That's the 3rd playlist. Things that I would die to hear. Like what am I crossing my lucky stars for? And you know, what am I gonna just lose my marbles over if we hear, basically. Oh yeah, it's called Hope to Hear, not Would Love to Hear. Whatever, it's all just semantics. But yeah, I do think she'll play our song. If it's what one that I would rather hear that's like a big single from the first album is none other than Tim McGraw. I would rather hear Tim McGraw than our song. I love Tim McGraw. We will see. There's a chance we'll hear like more than one of these that I'm mentioning. The ones off debut that I would die to hear are obviously Should Have Said No. That's just my favorite off debut. And I rewatched Rep Tour today. She did Should Have Said No at Rep Tour. So maybe she will. I mean, maybe she won't because she just did it on Rep and like that makes sense. The other one that's kind of an underdog for sure, but I would die to hear is Cold As You. It's the first track 5 that ever was, and I don't think I've ever heard it live because she did not have a tour, I don't believe, for debut. She like opened for Tim McGraw or for Rascal Flatts, I think, but she didn't tour for it, and so I've never heard it live. Okay, moving on to Fearless, I think we're going to hear Love Story, and personally, I would rather not hear Love Story. I know it was kind of her big breakout song, so I get it. And for people who want to hear it, you know. Another kind of dark horse that I actually think we will hear, and I probably should have put this in the hope we'll hear category, is actually Mr. Perfectly Fine. Because I just think, like, the Joe Jonas of it all, and the Sophie Turner, the way she posted it and stuff, and I think she's gonna be really excited to play vault tracks from like these previous eras. Like that'll be a nice way of harmonizing or like combining, you know, hearing that older style of music, but still like giving the fans new songs. So I don't know, that probably should have been on the Hope to Hear It playlist, but I do low-key think we're gonna hear it. Hope to Hear off of Fearless. I'm going Fearless, You Belong With Me, and Forever and Always. You Belong With Me is like one of the singles that I have never detached from. I love it so much. And so yes, it's overplayed. Like at her tours, like I could definitely do without it or whatever. Like, I would rather hear stuff off Midnight's Folklore Evermore Lover instead of that. But, you know, if I'm going through the albums and assigning them to different categories, like, yeah, I would like to hear it. I hope to hear it. And then Forever and Always, for sure, like, hope to hear it. Okay, would die to hear, I only have one off of Fearless, and that is Breathe. And that is my favorite song off Fearless, and I've never heard it live. She never played it at the Fearless tour. So I'm not like optimistic we'll hear it, but I would die. Next, from Speak Now, I feel like I added a couple as I went, but from Speak Now, I think we're gonna hear Mine, and I think we're gonna hear Back to December. Speak Now really didn't have that many singles. Those were two of them, and so that's really the only reason I think that. Maybe she won't even because they weren't like huge songs, but maybe. What I hope we will hear off of that is Sparks Fly and Long Live. And she did Long Live, it was like the mashup with New Year's Day at Rep Tour. But Long Live is just such a good song, and it's like obviously for the fans. And I just think, what a moment to be in the room as she is like, she's gotten even bigger than she was since the last time she toured, and to sing Long Live, like, I just feel like would be iconic. Would die to hear off of Speak Now, I have Dear John and Enchanted. Although honestly, I would choose Dear John over Enchanted. I don't think that's the popular opinion. Enchanted is amazing. I did hear it during Speak Now tour. So yeah, preface, like, I've been to every tour. Hashtag blessed, I know. I'm not trying to brag. I'm just like, you know. So I'm also looking at all this through the lens of things that I have already heard or that we as a fandom have seen live, like whether it was like on the Lover in Paris thing or like when she performed some stuff at the Grammys, etc. Enchanted is amazing and I would die to sing it with everybody, but like Dear John would really put me over the edge. Okay, Red. I think we're going to hear I Know You Were Trouble and We Are Never Ever Getting Back Together. Those are obviously both really big singles, especially Trouble. They're great songs. I mean, as much as like the truth is, I would rather not hear any of the ones on this Think to Hear playlist and just save it for like, you know, deeper cuts on later albums, but it is what it is. They're great songs. Hope to hear Red, because I think that's when she might play and that would be fun to hear, and then would die to hear off of Red. I said Treacherous. I don't know if I stand by that. That might be more of a hope to hear. I love Treacherous, but I think I would put it on the chopping block for some others. I would simply die. Like, no, I mean, honestly, this is up there for me of like, if I only had to pick X amount, period, of which ones I would want to hear. And that would be Better Man and I Bet You Think About Me. Which, I Bet You Think About Me is just like a pure vault track, so I feel like there's a decent chance she would do it. I don't know about Better Man because, you know, it was like originally for another artist, but I would die to hear those. That takes us to All Too Well 10 minute version, because let's be honest, All Too Well original is kind of like not even part of the conversation, I don't think. I know there's like a whole thing of people either really want it or they don't want it because it's gonna take away 10 extra minutes. First of all, the song's really only like 8.5 minutes, which is still long, but at the end, it's just the fade out. Oh my gosh, I have hairs that are tickling me. So that's the first thing. It's not actually 10 minutes. Second of all, I kind of like a little bit wanted to be in the camp of like, yeah, it's really long, give us something else. But you guys, that is literally the best song of all time and everybody knows it. Like we all, I mean, I was telling my friend today, he goes, I feel like All Too Well original is dead to her, to Taylor. And I go, honestly, it's dead to me. And it was like the number one, my world orbited around that song for 10 years. So the fact that now it's dead to me, like I was like, oh, okay, interesting. So my point is just that the 10 minute version is so good. It is so, it's such a moment in time. And maybe she won't play the whole thing, but I mean, she has got to give us, she can do whatever she wants. You know what I'm saying? I think it would be cool if she maybe came in like, let's see, like right here, the second verse. Let's just give it a listen and come on, you know you wanna hear it. Or maybe she transitions from like another Red song into this part, I don't know, but we need to hear this part. We need to scream this with each other. Here we go. Come on. we're good at telling jokes. Like, we need it. You know what I'm saying? My personal opinion. Back to Think We'll Hear It for 1989. So that's obviously a huge, huge, huge album. Even on Rep Tour, she played a lot of songs from 1989. And I just realized that I don't think I put Bad Blood anywhere on here. She played Bad Blood at Rep Tour. It was obviously like a big single. So maybe it's on the Think We'll Hear It. I don't know. I guess part of me just doesn't want to hear it. I love it. I'm not, you get it. I'm not saying anything bad about any Taylor song. I'm just like thinking objectively or critically. I don't know. But I think we're going to hear Blank Space, Style, and Shake It Off. I think those are no-brainers. The question definitely comes into, like, how many medleys will she do? I don't know. Those are all great songs, obviously, but I kind of think, like, we're gonna hear them. That's just how it goes. I hope we hear Out of the Woods. So that was another big single off 1989 and one of my top three on that whole record. So I really hope we hear Out of the Woods. Like, her vocals, come on. And then my favorite song on 1989 is I Know Places. So I hope we'll hear I Know Places. I also love Clean. I didn't put that on here. I don't know, maybe at this point in me making the playlist, I was like, I don't think that's very realistic, but yeah. Okay, and then Would Die to Hear. Oh, I skipped it. I didn't put any Would Die to Hear for 1989. I mean, again, I, they all cross over, right? Like, I'm gonna die to hear her do anything. I'm gonna die to hear her say, hello, Swift City, because that's the name of the city and that we're like the opening tour stop. But anyway, okay, I think we will hear, moving on to Reputation. Another one I realized I didn't even like think about really was Look What You Made Me Do. She did it at Rep Tour. Obviously, that was Rep Tour. That was the first single. But yeah, kind of like Bad Blood, I'm just like, just leave it off. Like, it's a great song, it was a single, it's fine, but like, come on, you know, we're gonna hear other singles, so just maybe leave that one off. That's my hope. But I do think she's gonna play Delicate as far as the single goes from Rep. What I hope we will hear from Rep, Call It What You Want. That's my number one favorite song off Rep. Gorgeous, Getaway Car, and Dress. Now, again, the last tour she did was Reputation Tour. She played all of these. It's like available for us on Netflix, etc. So that's probably why they're not in like the Would Die to Hear category, but I'm obsessed with all of those. The only one I put for Would Die to Hear is King of My Heart. And that's because, I don't know, it's also in my top three. And I think partially because this is so corny, but my boyfriend's gonna be going with me. And like, Reputation is kind of like, we just love that album. So many of those songs remind me of him. And like when we started dating, he hadn't really listened to that album before. And I like shared so many of the songs with him and told him how they made me think of him. And I don't know. So King of My Heart would just be like the really special one, I feel like. But okay, after Rep, we're getting into the territory of, hi, my name is Taylor Swift. And I have four albums that I never toured for. Obviously, yes, there's all the vault tracks and stuff like that. But you know, we're getting into like full length albums. As you know, Loverfest never was. So I think we're gonna hear You Need to Calm Down, and I think we're gonna hear Me. I could totally do without them, especially Me, but what I will say is I'm a teacher and Me is such a good song to play for the little kids. They love it. It's totally clean and they love watching the music video. So there is a part of me where like, I love that song because I love that little kids love it. And I mean, in Miss Americana, wasn't it like Taylor even was talking about how she wanted little kids to like sing that song and like feel good about themselves. And one of my students is going to the concert. And like, so for those kids, I'm okay with us hearing it, but like, yeah, me personally, I could do without it. I love You Need to Calm Down. I actually love it more than I think the average fan does. But again, there's just so many songs off those last four albums. Okay, Hope to Hear from Lover. I put Lover. Now, Lover is a beautiful song. It's one where like we've heard it a bunch. She has played it, I feel like a lot, but you know, I've never heard it live and it's such a beautiful song. Like I would totally be happy to hear Lover. I also put on Hope to Hear, I Forgot That You Existed, Paper Rings, and False God. Like, would love to hear those. Would Die to Hear, and This Is a Non-Negotiable, would be, come on guys, I'm just gonna play it for you. You know what it is. I feel like as a fandom, we know what I'm gonna say. Do we not? We need it. We need it. We need it. I think that she knows that we need it. We need Cruel Summer. We need I Don't Want to Keep Secrets Just to Keep You. He looks up, grinning like a devil. Like, we need it. And I think we're going to get it. I hope. Okay, another one I would die to hear is Cornelia Street. Like, an iconic song. Love. Love, 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 love. And the way she sang Cornelia Street at the Lover Live from Paris thing is, like, so offensive. Like, those vocals were insane. So I'm personally, like, dying to hear Cornelia Street. Now, my number one favorite song off Lover is Death by a Thousand Cuts. So, like, in a way, you would think that's the one I'm dying the most to hear. It's so nuanced, you know what I mean? If you're, like, a true, like, obsessive in it Swiftie, you get what I'm saying. Because even though technically Death by a Thousand Cuts is, like, I like that song better technically than Cruel Summer. Although, again, that's, like, really hard to even, whatever. We have heard it live a couple times. She did it at the Lover in Paris thingy. She did it on Tiny Desk on NPR. And, like, I don't know. So I'm obsessed with it. I will die to hear it. I hope we get both. But, like, Cruel Summer needs to happen. I also put Daylight. That's probably could have gone in the, like, hope to hear it. But it's kind of, like, similar to that. Like, my boyfriend will be there thing. Also, I'm so sorry. I keep playing with my hair. Nobody cares. I'm aware. But I just know that I look a mess, so I'm gonna try to stop and just move on. Folklore is next. Folklore literally changed my life. I feel like it changed a lot of people's lives. I don't know. I said that I think we'll hear Cardigan. I could have put it on hope to hear again. I hope to hear everything. Like, I just want her to play literally everything. I will take Perfectly Good Heart. I will take anything. I will take anything you want to give us, Taylor Swift. But yeah, I do think we'll hear Cardigan because it was a single. I hope we will hear, oh, I didn't put anything on Hope We'll Hear for Folklore. Interesting. Probably because I put it all on Would Die to Hear. And that would be the one. Obsessed. Obsessed. Like, I have such a complicated relationship with Folklore. Like, it is just, in a lot of ways, it's like my favorite album of all time in the history of the entire world. But, like, I don't know. So, and, like, in a way, The One is my favorite song, but that's really, like, not accurate because there's so many different variables. But I would die to hear The One. I would die to hear My Tears Ricochet. I think that is one of the best songs she's ever written. It's so cutting and emotional and intense, and I would die to hear it. I would definitely die to hear August. August is one of the best songs of all time. It's so good. I would die to hear it live. There's just a part of me that's like, well, she did it at the Grammys, so, like, in my mind, it's like a little bit underneath some of these other ones, but Invisible String, one of my favorites, would die to hear it, would die. I'm gonna play you the next one I would die to hear because, like, if I hear this live. Can you imagine? You guys, this is happening tomorrow, like in 24 hours. If I hear this live, Taylor Swift's first recorded F word of all time, like. What did you think I'd say to that? Might not survive. Next one. Would die. Want to hear it so bad. She has sang it before, but okay. The next one is, well, I'll just tell you. So my friend Danny, he asked me, okay, what are your top three out of everything that you, like, want to hear so bad? And I told him, I already told you what one of them was, and that one is Cruel Summer. And, like, again, these aren't even necessarily my top three favorite songs. It's just, like, for a variety of reasons, these are the ones I, like, need to hear live. Like, please, 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 please. Cruel Summer is one of them. My next one is what I'm going to play for you next. And I think it's the one that has the least chance of these three to be played. But Lord Almighty, I would fully pass away if I heard this live. Here we go. Peace. No, I can never give you peace. Like, that song is so moving to the core, and it's so beautiful and amazing, and I just feel like that would be so impactful to hear that live. Kind of similar, honestly, in the same vein that is just so impactful to me is Hoax. Which is, I think, a really underrated song, and again, I don't think there's, like, a super high chance of that one being played, but yeah, Cruel Summer and piece are on my list, and I will tell you number three when we get to it. Okay, next album, we have Evermore. I didn't put anything for Evermore on Think We'll Hear, although, oh, that's probably why. Because Willow is on Hope We'll Hear, and I do kind of think we'll hear Willow because that is kind of like the single or whatever. I love Willow. I have a Willow lyric neon light on that wall right there. I love Willow. We have heard it several times. And when I say we've heard it, it's like obviously not me. Like a lot of us haven't heard it live, but I just mean she has done performances of it since it's been out that like are available to watch on the internet. I hope we'll hear Gold Rush. I hope we'll hear Nobody No Crime. And I definitely think that the LA shows when Haim's there, I definitely think we'll hear it. I hope we'll hear Long Story Short. I hope we'll hear It's Time to Go. Honestly, again, like Evermore, I mean, I'm leaving certain songs off, but I would pretty much die for pretty much any song on any of these albums. But you know, how many prefaces can I really do? Would die to hear from Evermore. Champagne Problems. I know I'm not alone. I know that's a fan favorite. I know that that bridge is insane and that we all want to scream it, and I would die to hear it. I would die to hear 'Tis the Damn Season. That's definitely one of my favorites. I would die to hear Happiness. I would die. I don't know if it's gonna happen. It's a long song and it's like pretty melancholy, but oh my gosh. This is one of the most psychotic songs of all time. Like, it is so moving to the soul, to the core, to the being. I would die. This is like up there for
Honey When I'm Above the Tree.
Like, if I had to choose my top five, I don't know, of what I, like, that might be on there. It's insane. Next that I would die to hear, it's basically the whole entire Evermore album, but it's
How's One to Know I Need You by the Spirit.
I really hope we hear Ivy. I think there's a chance we will, and I really hope we do. Then we have Cowboy Like Me, love it. Evermore, which is like kind of my favorite song off the whole album. I don't know if we'll hear it because Bon Iver is featured. Maybe she'll do part of it, but again, deeply moving song. And then bonus tracks, hello, this song. Can you imagine this live?
Friends break up, friends get married, strangers get born, strangers get buried, transgene.
Can you fathom? Can you imagine the build and like singing with everyone? Like, oh my God, what an experience. Okay. Oh, here's one off Folklore that I realized I would also die to hear live. And that is, ooh, hello. And that is, let me just play it for you.
Rebecca rode up on the afternoon train. It was sunny.
I just think, again, that would be so special to hear that with an arena, a stadium of people and sing that. And the part where she says, then it was bought by me and the pause. Like, I just think that would be crazy to hear that live. Okay, back to Think We'll Hear. Now we are up to Midnights. Oh, I realized, see, here's another one that got added. From 1989, I think we'll hear Wildest Dreams too. But, okay, Midnights. I think we're gonna hear kind of a lot. I don't know. It's so hard to tell because this goes back to the like, what route is she going? Is she really doing like, here are five songs or three songs or however many from like each era? Or is she doing like, let me make it up to you the last four albums plus a sprinkling of some of the older ones? Is that theory that like, depending on who the opener is, will depend on the set list and she has different set lists for each tour? Does that theory have any merit to it? Like, it really just depends. But one thing that I think for sure we're going to hear is, I mean, come on, you know what it is. You know what it is. And I hate to even have any ounce of like, well, now that's such a big single. Like, I don't want to hear it. Because that's not true. Like, that song is amazing and I love it so much. But I don't know. They, singles, they just have that to them. They just have that effect where like when you hear Blank Space for the 9,000th time, you like forget that it's actually a deeply iconic song, you know? And like, that's kind of how Antihero is for me. But I mean, I love it and I'll be stoked to hear it. But I definitely think we'll hear it. Okay, then Hope to Hear. God, you guys, my hair. Okay, there's a lot from Hope to Hear. I do think we're gonna hear this one too. I think she's gonna open with this, unless she goes the route of debut, Fearless, blah, 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 chronological. I think she's going to open with this. And I mean, hello, sign me up. I wore lavender eyeshadow right now, actually, because my sweet mom, yeah, I showed you, if you watched the vlog portion of this, she bought me that Rem Beauty, like, glitter purple shadow, and I wanted to play with it tonight. So here's another one that I actually do think we're going to hear, but it's like, I hope we hear it, like, more so than Anti-Hero, and that would be...
Summer went away, still the yearning stays, a play.
You're on your own, kid. It's such a good song. The line about the friendship bracelets, like, people are going to want to sing it. They're going to want to scream it. Another one that I definitely could see us hearing, and I hope we do, is Bejeweled. Now,
baby,
the problem is if she does all these midnight songs, I mean, that really takes up a lot of time. But anyway, another think slash hope is... I mean, it's just like such a deep fan song. And it's such a boppy, fun song. I think she's gonna have a blast like doing that one live. So I definitely do think we'll hear that, but I do hope to hear it. It's on my playlist. One of my favorites off Midnight, it's such a sweet song, is Sweet Nothing. And so I hope we hear it. I don't know if we will. And then another one that's a 3 a.m. track is The Great War. Love that song. I'm not so sure we will, but I hope we'll hear it. And that leaves us with the Would Die to Hear section of Midnights, which leads us to my third, like, song that I need to hear. She could sing these three songs and I would be good. So I told you, Cruel Summer, Peace. And the third one is the deeply iconic Maroon. If you didn't watch my reaction, or rather, if you did watch my reaction video to Midnight, you would have seen, like, I absolutely lost every last semblance of a marble that I had when I heard that song for the first time. Like, it is so good, and I know that, like, it's a fan favorite, and, I mean, you guys, we obviously want to scream the part that we all want to scream in Maroon, like, it needs to happen. I do think we'll hear it, but I'm like nervous and I need to hear it. So yeah, Cruel Summer, Peace, and Maroon. I think we're gonna get Cruel Summer and I think we're gonna get Maroon. I think Peace is really going on a limb for me there, but like, hopefully. I would die to hear this, and I think we will. It's such a bop. I can see it now with everyone singing it. The next ones are 3 a.m. tracks. And I know I'm not alone in like low-key, some of the 3 a.m. tracks are some of my favorite songs on all of Midnight's. And so the next four are 3 a.m. We may or may not hear these, but I would die to hear each one of these. First one being Paris. Such a bop, so much fun. I think it would be so fun live. Absolutely. Next one. High Infidelity. Like, I'm obsessed.
Love broken, slurs spoken.
Next one that I would die to hear live, 3 a.m. Glitch.
We were supposed to be just friends.
I feel like that's an underrated song. So again, I don't know that we'll hear that one. Maybe like High Infidelity or Paris, but I don't know about Glitch, but I love it. Bigger Than the Whole Sky, I just want to say, is not on here, mostly because, or Dear Reader, I mean, I love those songs, I do. I love them all. Bigger Than the Whole Sky, I think I would die to hear, but I think I would actually die to hear it. Like, it's too emotional, so I left that off. But the last one, you guys, can you even fathom this girl getting out there and singing Dear John, and then also later singing Would've, Could've, Should've? Can you imagine? Can you? I mean, maybe I changed my piece choice to this, but just because this song is like, the vocals are insane, I think it would be insane to be in the room when she sings this live. I think it would be insane. I don't know if she would though, because it's like a pretty like, ooh, song, but I don't know. You guys, can you imagine? Let's fast forward and just like vibe out and pretend that we're there live.
Yeah.
Yeah, I might need to swap out my deep desire of hearing Peace live for that one, just because I'm not really convinced we're gonna hear Peace either way, or would have, could have, should have. So if I'm gonna have like a far-fetched dream, I might need to change it to what it could have, should have. I just think that song is like, I don't know. Yeah, it would just be like living in a moment in time in history to hear that song live. And so, you guys, that is my playlist. Like, there are obviously so many other songs, like The Other Side of the Door, and I mean, she's releasing tonight, like, you know, Eyes Open and Safe and Sound, and If This Was a Movie. Like, there's so many other amazing new romantics, and there's eons and eons of amazing songs, like everything this woman does. I would die to hear everything, like I'm so excited. But those are my predictions, those are my thoughts, those are my manifestations. I would love to hear your guys' thoughts. And if you are going to the tour, you guys, let me know like what city, what date, like what you think, what you're excited about. Like, just let's just talk, because I am freaking out in a good way. So, okay, I'm gonna end this whole video here. It was part vlog, part this, and I'm gonna pick up vlogging again tomorrow, which is the day of the first show. So yeah, I still need to finalize my outfits and all that kind of stuff. So I will take you along on that journey in next vlog. Love ya. Bye.